So now that we know the definition of a PRNG, let's take a look at some examples. It turns out one example of a PRNG has been hiding in plain sight all this time. When we talked about CTR mode, we said that CTR mode kind of behaves like one-time pad, where the pad, the random value that you use to XOR with the plaintext, is generated from block cipher outputs. So if you just take the top half of this diagram, where you are generating that random pad, that itself is a PRNG. The seed is the nonce and the key, the true randomness that you pass in, and the block cipher outputs are the pseudo-random output that is being generated by this PRNG. So the counter mode-based PRNG is one possible construction you can use to build a secure PRNG, and this is based on the fact that block cipher output is indistinguishable from random, so the output of this PRNG is also indistinguishable from random. Another way to build a secure PRNG is actually based on HMAC. So remember that HMAC is itself based on hashes, and also remember that hash output is unpredictable. If you change any bit of the input, the output looks totally unpredictable. So we're going to use that idea to build our PRNG. So that construction might look something like this. Now, don't worry too much about the exact details here. It's not the most important thing. Just remember that what's happening is we're calling HMAC a lot of times, and the unpredictability of that underlying hash is what's giving us our unpredictable output. But if you're curious, here are all the exact details, although they are not the most important thing here. So the HMAC-based PRNG has two instance variables, K and V, and they just so happen to start at zero. And anytime you call seed or reseed, notice that we're taking that seed S, we're passing it into HMAC to cause some unpredictable output to appear, and then we reassign K and V to the output of that HMAC. So in effect, we are incorporating the randomness that you have introduced into our instance variables K and V with the help of HMAC. Now, if you want to generate output, it might look something like this. So there's a loop, and the loop calls HMAC repeatedly until enough bits have been outputted. So if you ask for a lot of bits, this while loop will run a lot of times until HMAC has been called enough times to generate enough output. Also, every time we call HMAC, we also update one of the internal variables V, which we then pass back into the HMAC, and this ensures that every call to HMAC produces different output every single time you call it in this loop. So again, don't worry too much about the exact details here. The important thing is just that we're calling HMAC in a loop and updating the internal state every single time, and this is what produces the random looking output. And again, at the end, we update the internal state, not too important, but this is what HMAC-based PRNGs might look like. And one thing to notice here is that everything here is deterministic. It's all based on the user inputs S and N, and at no point are we actually using true randomness here. The code itself is deterministic, and the true randomness is inputted by the user. This is why we say that PRNGs are deterministic. They take in the true randomness from outside, where the user provided S, and then they deterministically generate pseudo-random output. The HMAC-based PRNG is secure, assuming that the underlying hash that you're using is secure. We're not going to prove it in this class, we're not a proof-based class, but if you're curious, the proof would be something like a reduction proof, where it says, if you can break HMAC, you've also broken the underlying hash function. Therefore, if the underlying hash function is secure, then HMAC-based PRNG is also secure. So we're not going to talk about the proof, but the outline would look something like that. Another great benefit of the HMAC-based PRNG is that it is rollback resistant. And remember, that property means you cannot run the HMAC PRNG algorithm in reverse. Even if someone told you the current internal state, that is the values of K and V, those internal instance variables, you cannot run this algorithm in reverse to figure out the previous outputs of this PRNG. And the reason why is because this PRNG was calling hashes all of the time, calling HMAC over and over again, and HMAC is not something you can call in reverse. Given the HMAC output, you don't know what the input is, so you can't run this algorithm in reverse. So in summary, HMACs, they are secure, they're indistinguishable from random, and they are also rollback resistant. We have that extra property where you cannot run the algorithm in reverse. And one thing I haven't mentioned that I might as well do now, DRBG stands for Deterministic Random Bit Generator, and that's just another name that people use for PRNG sometimes. So it's a lot of acronyms, but that's what DRBG is.